The creators of Throne Room Reviews would like to say that this is a fan-made show. We do not own any of the copyrighted material used within the episode. All copyrighted material belongs to their respected owners. Any copyright infringement is non-intentional. This message has been brought to you by Plan 12 Entertainment. Friends, and welcome to Throne Room Reviews. Now we move on to Season 11, and I will say this, there are going to be less clip gags in the next few reviews. The episodes are so stupid I can't do anything funny with them. This time we'll be looking at Thomas and the Spaceship. Already I can see great things from this episode, and by great, I mean stupid. The story begins with Thomas helping a broken down Percy back to the sheds. Percy, with the IQ of an idiot, sees moving and flashing lights in the sky and assumes it's a spaceship. With Percy out of the action, Thomas has to deliver the post completely on his own. And here we lose continuity, as always. The Season 3 episode, Thomas, Percy and the Post Train, one of my favourites, gives us the reason why both engines pull the train.
One train is pulled by Thomas and the other by Percy, as the loads are too heavy for one engine to do the work alone.
And yet, this episode throws that away just to keep Percy out of the episode. Anyway, while Thomas is delivering the post, or failing to, he comes across a lot of flashing light, and like the magic lamp 2 seasons ago, there is no spaceship, and the reasons why are stupid. Ultimately, Thomas finds that the lights that Percy saw was from Jeremy the plane, who was completely pointless in the grand scheme of things and was just there to fuel merchandising. After Thomas returns, he explains to Gordon his situation, that he hasn't been able to deliver the post because of his spaceship spotting, which violates about half a dozen railway regulations, and he needs Gordon's help to deliver the post in time, which Gordon agrees to. So the episode ends with all the engines watching Jeremy land from the sheds, which means the airport is only about a mile, if that, from Tidmouth, because this script does not know geography. This episode is harmless but really stupid. The plot is generic and relies on the overused three-strikes-you're-out formula which dominates the Sharon Miller era of Thomas and Friends. Thomas is an idiot, Percy is an idiot, and the only speaking character I liked in this was Gordon. He says just what I would say in this situation.
How many spaceships did you find?
And does the right thing by helping Thomas. So there is some common sense in this era, however it's hardly used as we'll see in future episodes. This is King William saying, hope to see you soon on another Throne Room Review.